My self-esteem had been shattered so much that my number one goal was just find a way to prove to myself, or to even to prove to him, that I was worthy and people wanted me, and that he had made a mistake. I met my husband when I was 18. I had just graduated high school. We had lived together for a couple years, and then we'd been married for about a year when I discovered that he had been having an affair. It just really devastated me, and I didn't really know how to comfort myself. I just kind of took on that persona of, I'm going to be the prettiest, I'm going to be the sexiest, the most desirable, I'm going to be the wild, crazy girl that everybody wants, and I just pursued that. I kind of reconnected after my divorce with some friends from high school that I'd lost touch with for a few years. And of course, they were all out kind of in the bar scene. The social life just kind of began to just take over me and my identity. A lot of the people that I was friends with were really kind of big city drug dealers, and a lot of them worked or ran some of their drugs out of strip clubs or a lot of kind of the higher end clubs. I was very caught up in it. We would go to these really high end clubs. We would go back to the VIP section, the private rooms, where we would just do whatever drugs we wanted to do. They were always available. I never had to pay for them. We would just walk in and be given bottles of champagne. It was just like I had found this association through these people that I was hanging out with that just had this lifestyle that presented itself as so glamorous. I did not know that my lifestyle was hurting me, because I was successful. I owned my own cleaning service. I went to work every day. I was a completely 100% functioning alcoholic. And I justified my lifestyle by thinking, I'm a young woman, I've went through this divorce, so I felt like I had permission to just act this way and live this lifestyle for a few years, and then I'll grow up later. I maintained that for a long time until I just started getting caught up more and more. My brother had invited me to go to church with him on Easter. That was the first time I had ever heard the gospel. Something inside me said that this isn't for me right now, because I would have to clean up a lot of things and I would have to change a lot of things, but maybe one day. After I had gone to church that Easter, I was living with my friend in a place where we had a lot of parties and there was a lot of drug use. And all of a sudden, people that we knew, the people that would come to our parties, the drug dealers that we hung out with, were starting to get arrested. We had heard that our apartment was being watched, and we felt like we needed to separate. I ended up moving, and so some time had gone by. We had decided we would meet for dinner one night. We met for dinner at the place where we always went for happy hour, and we did start having some drinks, and it was just a few hours later we were on the phone making calls, going to pick up a bag of cocaine. We were back at her house and we were doing drugs. I was so high on cocaine, she was able to go to bed, and I felt disgusted. And I just sat on her couch and just cried and cried. I don't even know what made me think to pray or what made me think of God, but I did. And I just cried out and I begged the Lord. I said, if you are out there and you are real, please show me. And if you will give me a different life, I will be anybody you want me to be, and I will do anything that you ask me to do. I felt a sense of peace after I prayed that prayer. I knew that it was the only hope that I had. It was still a process for me, but little by little, I started going to church on a regular basis. Once I really started learning who Jesus was, immediately the Lord took me on a journey to discover my identity in Him. And I started realizing I didn't have to pursue being special, that I was already special. I just find that with Jesus, I meet the standard, where in the world said, fit this image, this is what beautiful looks like. That's a standard I'm never gonna attain. But in Jesus, I already meet the standard. I'm already beautiful because He created me and He defines my identity. And when I come to know myself in Him, then I already measure up.